administration, sorry. Let me humbly invite the microphone. I know His Excellency has a voice that can be a bit fast to come and address the National Working Committee. Excellency, Executive Governor, River State, Governor Nyesom Ezenewo Wike.
Why am I criticizing the Republican say, I don't need to be in the Council of State if it did not meet the agenda of the meeting. But even if I was in the meeting, and I said, this is not supposed to be, it will not stop them from taking this decision. The point is, you told this country that you are fighting corruption. Whether it's real or not, I'm not going to practice today, it's not real. You said one of the things you must do for the is to fight corruption. Fine. People who are charged with us from the FCT High Court, now the government, the Supreme Court. This is also the same movement that I criticized the judiciary of not supporting them to fight corruption. Now, people were jailed, whether they committed offense or not, as far the court has said they committed. We spent money on the investigation, not mean money. And then what happened? Because we are going to the church to you, we never went and released them. What signal is that? That fighting corruption is fake. That fighting corruption is not real. And I told them that they should be banned, the FCC, they are no need. Because if they can take all the energy to prosecute, at the end of the day, the same government that says they are fighting corruption. So for me, these are things we should not allow. We cannot continue to allow deceit. The present ABC government has deceived us. Now, of all the aspirants, nobody should talk about sentiment. Nobody should talk about, oh, look at how his face is. You don't need my face. All you need is to win an election. You don't need my face. You don't need to know how scruffy my voice is. What is important? Can we get win this election for the People's Democratic Party? The answer is yes. You don't have to look at what the elites are saying. Put your ear down. Who are they talking about? The classroom, who are they talking about? Why are they talking about Wike? Because in this country, everybody has seen what I've done in River State. You must show, where is their result? This is the period you went to school. And at the end of the semester, your parents will ask you, show me your result. By the time you have come to commission project and to flag a project. So I have shown you my results. You are the chairman of the party. So many of our party leaders from the north, from the south, from the east, from the west. I'm not denying that I've not declared their party leaders for flag off and commission project. What basic thing they must know? That this is the only opportunity PDP has. This is the only opportunity that PDP has. If we lose this election in 2023, the only way God will forbid is give the man who has the capacity to win the disconnect between the party and government. As a president, you want from time to time to talk with the party leadership. Party leadership will talk to the National Working Committee. There are layers of leadership. They talk with the National Working Committee. They talk with the Board of Trustees. They talk with the caucus of the party. From time to time, say, listen, this is what government intends to do. What are your own views? That is the way there should be a synergy between the party and the. It's not why a party, a government will run a program without the party being involved. The party will not be in a position to defend that program because they are not aware of such a. The government wants to go to the National Assembly. The government must sit down with the party leadership, see what they intend to do, what are your views before they go to the National Assembly. I've seen that. That has never been the case. In those days, in Gambia, 1979, that was there one party was strong. The government at that time cannot do anything without the leadership of the party. I have tried it in my state. And it has worked. Most of you who come to the university will always see me with my leaders trying to find out what I'm going to do, what I'm not going to do. It is not easy. It's a tax that every person in government to carry the party. That is what I think. If I'm given the opportunity, that I go to the lives of the party, find out the views of the party, and then that synergy, you see how it goes. So when the party begins to talk differently, and government says something different, there's something is there. And that is what I think any government should have at that time. Secondly, why would we continue to allow APC, who have promised Nigeria heaven and earth? Today, from 2015, we're hearing Boko Haram only in Burundi and Yobe. Today, terrorists and bandits have taken over the entire country. It's no longer Yobe and Burundi. It is not that system and Chelsea. So Nigerians are really tired. But again, Nigerians are waiting. Who am I going to present? What is the track record of that person? What is the track record? Where you were? What did you do? As at the time you were there, what happened? What happened? So that is what is important. Not those you give tickets tomorrow, they fail, they will use them in the party game. Or you don't give them ticket, they pick them up for the party. No, that is not the way it's supposed to be. So I believe that true party person and the true party person should be encouraged to lead the party. It's very, very important. And I want to say clearly too, I know the modus operandi of APC. I can withstand APC, I can withstand the federal government. That's the difference. And I want to say it here, poverty does not know north. Poverty does not know south. Insecurity does not know Muslim. Insecurity does not know Christian. It is something that a leader must defend and take that decision. If you remember, sometimes ago, the first statement, where people should know what to do. People were already relocated their companies to Lagos. It was that bad. Well, as someone who is at the head of affairs, I call the security leader, listen, what is the problem? What can we do? I'm not a security man. I'm not an expert. But you are, but you're a professional. What is the problem? And they told me, if you can get all this ABCDB, I can assure you security will it's not only giving you, I will see what you want. Where do you get it from? I don't want more tomorrow, so that one technical fault, I don't want that. We said I'll give them timeline. From social time to social time, if you don't see improvement, obviously, you're not encouraging me to. And it's okay. For every person that will fight a fighting crime, and he or she loses his life or her life, the government will give the family such amount of money. It's not as if that money can buy him a thing, but it's to encourage them. It's an incentive. Encourage them. So if we will know that our fighting in vain if they die today, who takes care of our family? It's on record. If you read very well, there has never been a time that security agents died in course of fighting crime that I did not take care of the family. That is what it's supposed to be. in WhatsApp, a leader, who will see you, say this is black, and not to say it's white. If I say this is black, it's black. Even if all of you team up together, I will not be afraid. All the matter will come to you. Even if you hold me to now, that I will not go. I will go. when you team up, it makes me stronger. It makes me stronger. I'm not saying you're going to, but in case you want to. It's not very easy to have. I've gone from one state to the other. When we did our convention in 2018, about 10 people contested. There was no consensus. Why in 2019, why would you talk about a consensus? The primary was quite open. You know I supported America, but I have no regret. I don't support that. But one time one was, I carried the campaign over to my head. And that's what you're supposed to do. I don't believe in these people going around the consensus. I told them, what you're coming to tell me is shine, Bobo. What you do, the best you see. As I'm not going to buy that for you. And you know what you're doing, it will not work. It will not work. So I'm not a passionate. I believe in consensus, yes. They are able to just sit down there. But not consensus by people who have to spare. The thing that if you can bring me in, nobody can bring me in there. So I want us to know that this election is the determinant for us. It's a determinant. And history based on you now. Look at the conversion within 2018. It was acknowledged by the international community. Look at conversion within that brought you in. It was acknowledged by everybody. I want to please advise. Not to make any mistake of where people will see that voting is being tried to do it for one person or for a second person. Then, what we are doing is to destroy the party. Because our opposition party, we cannot afford where people say this election is not credible, this election is not transparent. And therefore, I plead again, we must not make a mistake of putting people in the convention committee, whatever, who are obviously supportive of me, or A, or B, or C. If we do that, then some of us will take challenge of it. So it is good. I let you know that we should do something that everybody will be happy. All the aspirants will be happy. People are voting, people are seeing what is going on. But if we do anything, it will be shaped. After we have done the one of 2018, we have done the convention that brought you in, then this should be a better convention. Why they are seated as members of National Working Committee. I would also advise, in this period we are in, this is a litigation period. There is no election time where you don't see litigation. That's not. Let nobody even tell you to pray that you don't come, it will come. There are things you don't pray. Because if Lord was so that we're not going to problems again, we should try as much as we can. If we cannot forget such matters, we should try as much as we can to see how we reconcile people. But don't say no, nothing will happen. No, as a Christian party, no impunity. When it comes to obeying the rule of law, respecting the rule of law, nothing can happen. How you can solve such issues. No issue that cannot be solved. If you are open, if you are firm, everybody will like that. So, Mr. Chairman, this I'm saying is for the delegates. When we finish, we will not tell Nigeria, because not every Nigerian that will vote here is a threat around something delegates. And so, the language for delegates is different from the language of general delegation. This is one way for delegates and for us. Once we win by 29, then Nigerians will see what we want to tell them. But whatever it is, all we should do, whether it's time, whether it's death, whether it's done, who can win this election for PDP? That's what it is. Not what somebody wants to run. then on the presidential election, you lose your state. You must assure that you win your own state before we will give you. But you know, that's one state that you say you close your eyes and win your other state. Since 1999, the records are there. We have given PDP the highest vote since 1999. In the whole of the South South last election, it was my state that APC never got 25%. And they will not also get 25%. So, let us work together. Don't say I criticize you, I will criticize you. That's why nobody can buy it. If you don't do the right thing, I will criticize you. So, I don't want to keep you on waiting to tell you that you must see people who have been doing, people who are willing to run for it. You must see people who have been moving to. I don't send anybody to go talk to me anywhere else. I want people to see me face to face. I don't want anybody to go and say what I didn't say. So nobody, I couldn't assign people to go and talk to you, no. I couldn't assign anybody to go and talk to very well, no. Or Imo State. No. I go personally. After most of them have been praying, they will say, but you know, the household name now is Wike. You know what I mean? The household name is like, Wike. So you do not make mistake to lose that Wike. It's not mistake and lose Wike. Then we have lost, it is not our prayer. So I thought I should take this opportunity and let you know that I'm prepared. I am prepared, fully prepared, psychologically, mentally, anything is here, very much prepared. So let's not be wasting time. Go and talk to your people. Tell them that no more wasting time. You have seen the right person and the right person. Thank you.
one of the 17 presidential aspirants is also here while His Excellency was presenting his speech. His Excellency Governor of Fire of the United States, Kelly.
Let me, on behalf of the National Working Committee, welcome our strong party leader, Governor of the University, presidential aspirant, the forthcoming election from Nyesom Ezenewo. I will start by apologizing. Generation. I assure you that no sabotage was intended. It's one of the maladies in this country which PDP is out to rescue. You can't run a country without power. And I think PDP will do better than what the current administration is doing. We are in a rather sad situation that even if we provide a generator or other power services, the power set that comes and goes destroy all your best arrangements. I remember I was in the villa with President Obasanjo one day and the power went off. And he was then the Minister of Power, and I said, this is an indictment on you, Mr. President. So it can happen to even the President, even the governors who are here, it can happen to anybody. So no sabotage was intended. Secondly, let me repeat what I have said over and over. Of our 17 presidential aspirants, each one will do better than President Wike. We have 16 men and one woman so far. And I believe each one of them will be a star president and Nigerians will be proud of. Nigerians should get ready to vote for the PDP, which has the best quality. Today you have listened to one of them, who is not just a presidential aspirant, but virtually a foundation member of this party. But as soon as we founded the party, people like Governor Wike joined. At the grassroots level, serve the party in various capacities and understand from local government chairman. They are rising all the way. So it's today one of the pillars of our party. And we are proud that they have held this party together and sustained what is obviously the biggest and best political party in this country. I want to thank you for the services you render to this party, and which we hope you will continue to render to the party. Exactly. On the one hand, you wants a level playing field from the National Working Committee. On the other hand, he wants the National Working Committee to canvass votes for you and vote for you. Any comment present, you have to choose one, you can't have both. Let me assure you that this National Working Committee will try to uphold the traditions of the Congo Democratic Party. And that tradition since 1999 is running very credible, transparent conventions, starting from JOS, the last one that will use this National Working Committee. I want to assure you that there will be no foul play, no manipulation. We will certainly do better than what we did in October last year. We will try to be the hindleg of the People's Democratic Party. We will not be partisans. We will try as much as possible to make sure that every member of the National Working Committee works for the party. But I want to also assure you that once you emerge as a candidate of the party, whoever emerges, from that point on, will be aggressively partisan, because want the party to win the election. We do everything in our power by way of canvassing to votes in the Nigerian people to ensure that the PDP wins the next election. Because a victory by a PDP candidate is a victory for everybody. And it is in that light that I particularly like your submission when you made it clear that win or lose, you will never leave the party. You will work for the party, you've done it before, and we are very sure that you will do it again. Not only did you say that, you also spoke on issues. You outlined your agenda in the summary form. You outlined those things you want to see the party to do. Never attack any individual. That is what we want from all of the mental aspects. That they should stick to issues. They should not attack themselves. By attacking each other, you undermine the party. Because you give the opposition the necessary ammunition to attack us when the candidate emerges. And secondly, when you attack yourself, you undermine your candidate also, because if you emerge as the candidate of the party, you need every aspirant, every member of the party to canvass for you. In many parts of the country, you alone cannot win elections. You need every member of the party to work for the party. I was very happy and listened very attentively, and you demonstrated that by talking about the issues that concern the party, that worry the country, security issues, economic issues, and all that. I want every member of the party who is running for election, from the lowest level to the highest level, particularly presidential aspirants, to stick to the issues, to decampaign the opposition, to promote the party, and make sure that we stick together, because only a united PDP go into this election and win the election. I have no doubt in my mind whatsoever that we are going to win the next election. We can only do so by uniting our party chapters in the world, in the local governments, and in the states. There are challenges in various states. We expect leaders like you and others to help resolve those challenges. The NWC is trying to do its best, but we can't do it alone. have to bring it to parameters. And once that is done, any action we take should never lose sight of the fact that our ultimate goal is not the ticket of the PDP. Our ultimate goal is to win the presidential election. Therefore, self-respect is very, very important, even where we are provoked or agitated. I want to thank you for always supporting this party. We're able to make sure that we put a strong and credible NWC, which is working coherently, to make sure and relentlessly, to make sure that we have a strong political party that will win and Nigerians will be proud of our performance. If and when you win, the ticket can win the presidency. I want to assure you that the party will stand firmly behind you in all policy discussions and all policy implementation, because you are right. If you don't have a strong political party, it's very easy for the president to gravitate to dictatorship. And this party was built on the foundation of democracy. The party will continue to support and strengthen democratic practices within the party and within the country. I want to assure you that no vote in this NWC